And good morning, everyone. Boy, you notice I got my jacket on. It turned cool on us last night. And since I'm kind of cold-blooded anyway, this hot coffee really, really tastes good this morning. Hey, thanks for joining me. My name is Don K. Preston. I am the president of Preterist Research Institute of Ardmore, Oklahoma. And this is what I call my morning musings. I'm sharing with you a little bit of a thumbnail sketch of defining covenant eschatology. As I've shared with you, all three futurist eschatologies believe the coming of the Lord, judgment, and resurrection occurs at the end of the Christian age, the end of human history. I believe the Bible teaches very clearly, very emphatically, that the coming of the Lord, judgment, and resurrection belongs to the end of the old covenant age of Israel that occurred in AD 70. We're currently looking at 1 Corinthians chapter 15. And as I noted in my very first presentation in this series on looking at 1 Corinthians 15, one of the very first things we have to notice and one of the very first things we have to honor is that whatever we might think about it, the bottom line reality is that Paul informs us in other passages and in 1 Corinthians 15 that the resurrection of which he writes was nothing but the hope of Israel. Now, I shared with you a couple of passages from Acts in the last segment. Notice Acts chapter 26, 21 and following now. Paul, standing on trial again, as he was in Acts 24 and in Acts chapter 26, 5 and following, Paul says, "And now having obtained help from God, I stand witnessing to both small and great," now watch this, "saying no other things than what Moses and the prophets said, that Christ would be the first to be raised from the dead and to give life and light to the Gentiles." Now, this is very, very emphatic. The force of the Greek cannot be denied. Paul's saying that his gospel, his eschatology, was nothing but what was found in Moses and the prophets. And what does he say about Christ, number one, being the first, did you catch that? The first to be raised from the dead. Now that means that since Christ was the first, the Old Testament foretold the harvest as well. Well, of course it does, as we've already seen. So, the resurrection of 1 Corinthians 15 is Paul's iteration of his eschatology. But Paul's gospel was nothing but what Moses and the prophets said should happen. Therefore, the resurrection of 1 Corinthians 15 is about nothing but what Moses and the prophets said should happen. You see, this is critical because in so much of eschatology today, the Old Covenant is completely ignored. Amazingly, Dwight Pentecost said eschatology has nothing to do with the law of Moses. What? Paul said his gospel was nothing but what Moses and the prophets said. Paul Butler, an amillennialist, said prophecies of the second coming, and of course inclusive of the resurrection, are not to be found anywhere in the Old Testament. And of course, postmillennialists such as Joel McDermott, who I debated, well, they acknowledge that the resurrection is found in the Old Testament. They tried to divorce it from Israel and the end of Israel's age. You see the problem? All three futurist eschatologies seek to divorce their eschatology from Israel and the consummation of her age. That means that they're flatly contradicting what Paul said in Acts and even in 1 Corinthians 15. This is absolutely, fundamentally important. Now, in my book, "We Shall Meet Him in the Air, The Wedding of the King of Kings," which, by the way, is the very first and only full preterist commentary on 1 Thessalonians 4:13 and following, I developed this extensively, showing that all of the New Testament writers tell us emphatically, pardon me, that their eschatological hope was the expectation of the imminent fulfillment of the Old Testament promises made to Israel. If we overlook this fact, we are doomed to misinterpret 1 Corinthians 15 and 1 Thessalonians 4. You can order this book and read all of this overwhelming evidence for yourself. Go to my website, www.eschatology.org, www.bibleprophecy.com. Order the book, mention that you saw the offer on YouTube or Facebook, and I'll refund your shipping. And don't forget, don't want to overburden you with offers here, but don't forget that a lot of this information, the fact that Paul preached one hope, and that that one hope was the hope of Israel found in Moses and the law, I discussed this extensively in my debate with Joel McDermott, and it obviously caused him tremendous difficulty as he tried to divorce the eschatological resurrection from the one hope, the hope of Israel, the hope of Israel after the flesh. So, get yourself a copy of that as well. Hey, thanks so much for joining me for this morning's Morning Musings. Hope you have a great day. We'll see you on the flip side.